This is the Brandberg mountain range. It is located in one of the most inhospitable places on Earth, the Namib Desert. It is also known as the Dwarres Mountain. This mountain range is a dome-shaped granite intrusion that rises high above the surrounding desert. It has water and shelter, and over thousands of years, it has provided refuge to generations of nomadic hunter-gatherers. These people, the ancestors of today's San, left their mark on the rock overhangs, and the mountain is home to at least 45,000 individual rock art paintings. Among the thousands of rock art friezes, one group of figures stands out, and it also caught the eye of early European explorers. This frieze is painted on a rock overhang, located deep in the mountain along this dry Tsisab River ravine. In the frieze, an exquisite central figure dominates. This image has become the iconic rock art painting in Southern Africa, known as the White Lady of the Brandberg, and has been shrouded in mystery and controversy. The controversy was started by the first European explorer who stumbled across it in 1917. He said, "The Egyptian Mediterranean style of all the figures is surprising." Dr. Sam Shallis is the head of the Rock Art Research Institute at WITS and says the idea that Europeans created the art attracted a lot of attention in Europe.
By the time of the end of the Second World War, the very famous and eminent prehistorian, the Abbé Henri Breuil, who had become famous in Europe for having covered the discovery of Lascaux, very famous Ice Age paintings in France, came to this part of the world, and it was he that was responsible for calling it the so-called White Lady.
Breuil was influential, and the idea that there was an image of a white woman in ancient rock art in Southern Africa spread like wildfire.
So the painting became known as the White Lady, and people from all over the world came just to see it.
However, Shallis says Breuil's thesis was soon challenged by those who studied rock art and indigenous cultures. Dr. John Kinahan is an eminent Namibian archaeologist.
There was a huge argument about that, but it was very, very quickly resolved that there was no basis for that idea at all.
Instead, scholarly consensus was reached that what is depicted on the rock overhang is not a white female, but an indigenous male medicine man or shaman. And to this day, guides like John Duniseb, who took us to the famous rock overhang, explains this to visitors.
You can see, only men during that time, they carry the bow and arrow, not the lady. So right hand side, they carry the bow and arrow, other hand, they carry a stick when they using the shaman, the process, they use the stick, the medicine inside, yeah.
The Wildebeerscale Rock Art Center near Kimberley is a community-based rock art project on land owned by the Kung and Kwe San. It is perspectives provided by indigenous or local experts like Petrus Wilson that can help establish the White Lady's ultimate meaning.
Ek dink dis 'n goeie ding as indigenous mense betrokke is wanneer hierdie navorsing gedoen word. So ja, 'n mens kan nie rotskuns net op enige manier interpreteer nie.
The idea that the White Lady is a male shaman has been widely accepted until recently.
Now, an artist's analysis of the painting suggests that the image is indeed female and actually the depiction of a Viking woman who visited Namibia about 1,000 years ago.
This idea was proposed by prominent Namibian architect and artist Linus Malherbe, who carefully studied the detail of the frieze. He also put the theory forward in a lecture at the Namibian Scientific Society and published it in a recent book.
She, to me, is medieval, from European descent, and definitely female.
He bases his theory on the notes and a sketch made by Breuil and a 1945 photograph. He says the figure lacks a penis, while all the male figures in the frieze have clearly defined ones. She also wears a barbette or medieval chin strap that only women wore. Malherbe further says that the figure has European features with long red hair. She's also wearing shoes, which is very unusual.
She's not a bushman, a medicine man, or shaman.
Malherbe has also created a large artwork in which he depicts the White Lady as a white medieval female warrior of Viking descent who came down the coast of Africa to Namibia with a group to engage in gemstone trading. He believes the painting was created by this group and elements in it fit perfectly with the medieval period. For example, the central figure carries a European-style asymmetrical recurve bow and she has archer's cuffs. The metal tip of the arrow is unusual for Africa. She also wears a wide leather belt and leather armor over a medieval gambeson. He further says the figure is wearing shorts or leggings, something which Boy also referred to in his notes.
And he described it in detail, the red strappings at the very top and how it was fastened.
Malherbe says, in general, his work has been well received so far, but realizes that it flies in the face of current scholarship on the interpretation of rock art. However, his ideas have also attracted overseas attention, says UK-based historian and art historian Mark Callahan, who specializes in the Viking era.
I think with Malherbe's hypothesis, I think it deserves some respect, actually. I think it's very intriguing and at times compelling. So we have the thick, wide Viking belt, we have the asymmetrical bow, we have the Viking-style shoulder strap. These are all indicative of Viking culture. So I certainly don't think it should be dismissed.
However, Callahan also points out that the painting has not been dated yet, so it could be from medieval times or date back even further. There is also no archaeological evidence of Vikings traveling further down the coast of Africa than Morocco. And Callahan adds that there is no evidence that Vikings ever traded in sub-Saharan gemstones. This, he says, makes many scholars hesitant to fully support Malherbe.
So no one really dismisses the possibility, and that there seems to be some evidence that points to his conclusions, but no one can really commit to it being anything more than a possibility. That the evidence simply isn't strong enough for anyone to be certain and put their names to it, for instance.
Local rock art researchers and archaeologists find Malherbe's revival of an old controversial theory deeply flawed.
Yes, well, the White Lady is a myth. It's a story that has been cooked up to suit people's agendas at various points in time.
He says it goes back to preconceptions that were prevalent when Europeans first found the paintings.
The thinking in those days was that because these images were so incredibly beautiful, they couldn't have been made by simple people like the Saam.
Furthermore, Challis says Boy deliberately altered his sketch to make the figure appear female and excluded a penis. However, a detailed copy of the painting from the 1970s clearly depicts a decorated penis similar to that of another male figure in the frieze. The face also differs markedly from Broy's sketch. In addition, Challis says scholars agree that rock art cannot be interpreted in any arbitrary manner.
Rock art is the expression of the intensified religious and ritual life.
It's not just a record of events. These people, like you and I, they didn't necessarily write diaries on the rock face, nor are the images of antelope some sort of menu of things that they like to eat. My colleagues and I would say that you have to come at it from a San perspective, or as close to a San perspective as you can possibly manage. And it clearly transpires that these are clearly visions. These are visions of the spirit world.
If viewed from such a perspective and combined with knowledge of cultural and religious practices, experts say everything in the frieze can be explained.
Look, I've had a look at Linus Malherbe's work. I think it is wonderful. His artistic work is extraordinary. I admire it. But his thinking with regard to the material that I'm familiar with, his thinking is simply wrong.
So it seems that archaeologists and rock art specialists have been in agreement that the White Lady of Duarez is in fact a male shaman and not a woman.
Malherbe's controversial theory has again focused attention on this remarkable figure in the Namib Desert. It is still known as the White Lady, and it still captivates those who come to see it. And while scholars are adamant that it is indigenous religious art, Malherbe maintains there still remains a mystery to be solved.
We have a very interesting case with evidence that should be respected, and we have doubts and not strong enough evidence to be conclusive. So we need further stronger evidence that places this group of possible Iberians and a female Viking descendant in Namibia. Until then, it will be a myth rather than reality.